Hey guys, welcome to Fit to Fight Republic. I'm Hope with FightFlex. I'm coming to you live from On Track Yoga Studio in Mount Holly. Hope you guys are having a great week so far. I realize it's only Tuesday. So today we're gonna start with some postures, I guess we normally do, on the ground, a little bit of breath work, then we'll get into a slow but full body practice today. So thank you for joining me. And we're just gonna go ahead and find a comfortable seat. And if you can, just gently cross your legs. If you notice that you have super tight hips, you can roll up a blanket, place it underneath you, or even a pillow. That's gonna change the angles of your hips. And it's gonna also help you release through your knees. So if you notice that your knees are way up here, couple of different things that you can do. The pillows, one underneath each. You can sit on something. I know I just said that. And eventually, after working on this, your hips are gonna start to release, but it can take some time. So be patient with yourself. And as we're in this easy seat today, just go ahead and make sure that there's some space. So it doesn't have to be perfect. If you do have super tight hips, knees, whatever gets uncomfortable, just take them out as wide as you want today. And then just allow your body to become heavy. Hi, Nancy. Thanks for joining us. And you can close your eyes if you don't want to do that. That's okay. And just focus on sensations in your body. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to change anything. Just where you're at. Even if you're just listening and you're not actually hanging out and doing the practice, bringing your attention or your awareness to your body can be helpful. And then you can start to add the breath. Just start to inhale through your nose and then exhale through your mouth. Again, inhaling through your nose, exhale through your mouth. And then you can just begin to inhale and exhale through your nose or whatever's comfortable for you. Again, allowing your body to be heavy and grounded. And just kind of check in with yourself. Again, notice any sensations. Notice anything that's going on in your mind. If you're having trouble letting go of thoughts or you're thinking about what you've got to do next. And that's all okay. But just bringing some awareness to it. And let's see if we can sit up straight, trying to stack our shoulders over our hips. I think I've probably done this here before, but I'll do it again. If you bring your arms out like a W, that's gonna be where your posture should be. So rolling your shoulders back. Again, keeping your belly button towards your spine as we're here. And this is like your legit posture. Even if you're in a car driving around, you can just be like, oh, this is where I should be. We have a tendency to do this, to round, especially with a lot of our fighting stance, where we're protecting our chin and so forth. And just go ahead and bring your hands back to your knees. You can, again, if you want to pull your legs in a little closer, you certainly can do that. We're going to take our left hand over to our right knee, and our right hand is going to go underneath to our left knee. And then we're just going to drop our head, our chin to our chest. And adding in a little bit of movement, bring your chin toward the ceiling. Again, rounding through your spine, bringing your chin to your chest. And then coming back through the center, chin goes toward the ceiling. Nice. We'll do this a few more times. Give yourself enough time. You can move through it quickly. But give yourself enough time to really feel the movements and feel what's activated in your body as we're moving. And then go ahead and come back through center. We're going to take our right hand behind us, coming into a twist. Your left hand can stay on your right knee. And be gentle with yourself for this first one, so we don't have to get like all hardcore. Just a gentle twist. And breathe. As you start to open up, you may notice as you inhale that you're sitting up a little taller. As you exhale, maybe you start to rotate to where you can see the back of the room or wherever you're at. And then slowly release back to center. This time our left hand, or excuse me, our right hand goes to our left knee, left arm goes under to the right hand. And we'll do the same movement. So dropping your chin to your chest, allowing some rounding in your spine here. And then moving through the center, chin goes toward the ceiling. Exhaling or inhaling wherever you feel is needed. Just a few more times like this. Again, just noticing where you feel sensation, what feels good. Okay, back through center. It's time taking your left or your right hand, sitting down on the left or right, back behind you. Coming into that twist, right hand stays on your left knee. And breathe. Maybe notice one side feels better or feels easier or smooth than the other, and that's normal. Awesome, coming back to center, great. We're just gonna find, our first one, we'll find some stillness and then we're gonna add in some dynamic movements. So taking your right hand down to the mat, you're gonna bring your left arm over your ear. And then really reach that hand towards the side of the room here. Really stretching through your side body. Maybe start to bring your right elbow or right forearm toward the floor. And just notice if that left hip starts to come up, we just want to back out a little bit. Because we're trying to keep our hips grounded here as we're reaching towards the opposite side of the room. Nice, go ahead and come back up. This time, left hand down to the mat, right arm comes over. Again, maybe you start to bring your forearm or elbow down to the ground. Really stretching through the side body, watching what's going up on going on your right side. So if the hip really starts to come off, you just need to back out a little bit. And breathe. And then we'll add in a little bit of movement. So we're just going to move from one side. You don't have to come all the way down. You can if you want to. And then back to the other side. Inhaling and exhaling where you feel like it's most needed or it's easiest to do. Awesome. Just a few more times. And you know, give you guys yourselves a hand for showing up and checking this out, and you know, hopefully you're working or doing some of it. Any of the videos that FightFlex is offering, because it's a big deal. We're gonna come onto our tabletop. It's a big deal that in the midst of all of this, that you know, you guys have home practice and. That you're still sticking with things that are important to you. So don't take that as being something minimal. It's quite impressive. So spreading your fingers here, pressing your palms into your mat, keeping your core engaged. And just breathe here for a moment. I feel how strong the structure is. Then you can start to drop your belly, bringing your hips and your chin toward the ceiling. And then rounding everything, pulling your belly button to your spine. And then you can just start to move with your own breath here, adding in any kind of C curves or even little circles, anything that might feel nice in your body. And remember, you can get creative because no one can see you except who's at your house right now, so yeah, really bring it forward, bring your bum back to your heels, whatever works for you. And you can you're like, none of it's working for me. Well, it's okay. Find something else to do. And then we'll come back to the center here. And we're going to come into child's pose. So taking your knees wide, your toes to touch, and then you're going to push back. If you have super tight hips and that's not really, you know, an option for you, or it feels terrible, then you can come back to this position. You can extend your arms out further, just staying higher more in a kneeling position. But find what works for you. Taking a breath here. Again, getting in touch with the sensations that arise for you. Notice where the sensation is. Notice if you start holding your breath. And all the stuff that I'm saying, I know I've said it many times or quite a bit, but it's important to remember, and not just here when we're on our mat or on the floor. It's also really good information when you're doing any kind of activity. When you're doing your martial arts, when you're doing cardio, when you're driving, to bring your attention back to your breath, back to where you're holding stress and anxiety and jaw on your forehead, and then see if you can't bring some, relaxation to that. Calm down your central nervous system. Walking your hands over to the right now, maybe you stack your palms, and then maybe you start to drop that left hip, left shoulder towards the floor, really getting it again into a side body stretch here. And breathe. Coming back through the center, and then walking your hands over to the left, you can stack your palms wherever you're at. Start to drop that right shoulder, right hip towards the floor. Stretching through the side body here on the side. And breathe. Coming back through center. We'll come back into this tabletop. You're gonna take the toes, walk your hands back into this toe stretch. You can even manipulate your toes a little bit if you want to. And then sit up tall, you can find your posture here, rolling your shoulders down your spine. And then breathe. And then remember to stay as long as you can. Remember, it's just a pose. Use your breath. Know that it's going to end. And if you have to come out of it early, that's okay. We're almost there. Notice what happens as you're, in some uncomfortable positions. Are you starting to hold stress in your face, in your jaw? Can you relax that until we come out of the pose? So linking back into your mat, tap the top of your feet. If you want, you can come back, bringing your hands behind you, lifting your knees just for an alternative or an opposite stretch, I guess. Nice. All right, come back into your tabletop. We're going to tuck our toes, coming into downward facing dog. I always like to turn my fingers out just a bit, changing the rotation of my shoulders, which protects my wrists. Then you just start to walk out your dog, stretching through your calves, working your heels towards the mat. And maybe that means keeping a bend in your knee. Maybe it means walking and changing your downward facing dog stance to where it's shorter. If you like movement, you can move one hip or knee towards the center and then the other. You like stillness, you can just work on getting your heels towards the floor. So as we're here, engaging through your core, so pulling that belly button to your spine, you're gonna bring your right hand back to your left ankle and pause here for a moment. Notice how that changes the stretch. And replace your right hand, left fingers to left ankle and pause. And we're just going to do that a few more times. So right hand, left ankle. Left hand, right ankle.
Few more times. Five, four, three, two, and one. Come back to them, facing dog. Drop your knees to hover over the mat. For five, four, three, two, and one. Go ahead and straighten your legs. And then just walk your feet to meet your hands, coming into your first forward fold. You can release your neck, shaking your head yes and no. If you have a bind, so maybe you want to grab your elbows or you can interlace your fingers, releasing through your shoulders. Again, you can always keep a nice bend in your knees, or you can start to gradually straighten your legs. Again, just focusing on your breath, focusing on the sensation that comes up for you here. Notice where you start to hold stress or tension, and then just breathe. Releasing your mind, we're going to come to a halfway lift, flat back. And release back down to your forward fold. Again, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. One more time, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. And then just start to gently roll all the way to standing. Nice. And just start to roll through your shoulders forward and back a few times. You can release your hands, and we're going to roll to our toes and through our heels, lifting our toes. Just finding a little bit of balance, or in my case, non-balance, I don't know. Depends on the day. Awesome. So we're going to start to put our weight on our left foot. You're going to take that right foot, bring it pinky toe to pinky toe. And you're going to take your left wrist and your right hand, and we're going to come into a side bend. If it doesn't work for you to do both, then just focus on either the legs or the arms, coming through that side body stretch. And you're not gonna, you know, we're not necessarily trying to go super deep. Just wanna hold a sound pose here. Really notice the stretch through your side body. Nice. Come back to center, release your arms. We're going to come into an IT band stretch. So go ahead and bring your hands to your hips. Pausing here. And then we're going to exhale into a halfway point. You want to keep your gaze forward. You're perfectly fine to stay right here. Or you can start to release your fingertips to your shins or maybe to the floor. Once you're here, soft neck. And then breathe. This is a pretty intense stretch as well. So just take your time here. We'll be here for a few moments to attempt to release through this IT band. Again, a good opportunity to notice where you start to hold stress, where the sensations arise, what you choose to do with the sensations. Can you breathe through it? Is it something that is painful that you need to come out of, or can you release a little further into the pose? Just a few more moments here. And then slowly bringing your weight back in your heels, arms can come to your hips. We're going to come to that halfway point. And then all the way back up to standing. Nice. Slowly and with control, you're gonna start to bring that knee into your chest or towards your chest. And sometimes balance is a tricky thing, and that's okay. We're gonna bring that leg behind us, and you can ground your toes, and we're just gonna come into a little plie or skater squat for a moment. Notice where your weight is.
bring that leg back through center, and then back to join the left. Awesome. And then we'll move on to this right side. So just cross the left foot over in front, pinky toe, thereabouts. Left, right wrist, left hand, coming into that side body stretch. And breathe. Nice, coming back through the center, releasing your arms, hands come to your hips. And then we'll come to this halfway point. Put this IT and stretch on this side. You can stay here, or you can start to release fingertips towards the floor. Again, using your breath to calm down your central nervous system, especially in these more intense poses. I mean, in all of them, but use your breath for your advantage. No matter where you are in the practice, even if you have to come out of it. And breathe. And that should be loose. And then gently bring your hands back to your hips. If they're not already there, we'll come to this halfway point. And then we'll come all the way up. Awesome. And then bring your knee back into your chest, finding your balance. It's okay if you're a little unsteady. It's part of it. Then bring that foot behind you. That's your skater's pose. Keep wanting to say the wrong thing. And breathe. Probably going to notice some sensation in your right hip. And then slowly and with control, you're going to come back through the center. Knee comes in towards your chest. And then release. Nice. Go ahead and take your feet wide. You can point your toes out towards the sides of the room to begin with. We're going to use do a few squat variations and then a few more folds, and then we'll go back down to the ground. So you can keep your hands on your hips. We're going to come into a squat. And breathe here. You can play with if you want, picking one heel off the ground, maybe both, playing with your balance. If that's not for you today, that's okay. Just keep your feet grounded. You can do one at a time. Just an opportunity to kind of test yourself. Really engage your core if you're coming off your heels here. Shoulders roll down your back. If your heels are lifted, go ahead and bring them down. See if you can come a little bit deeper into your spot here. And breathe. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to standing. Awesome. And breathe, taking your hands behind your back, opening up through your chest, lifting your chin toward the ceiling, keeping your belly button towards your spine. And then we're gonna exhale, coming into a forward fold here. Whoops. Full of bounce and challenges today. It's okay. It's the way I like it, you know that. And breathe. If this isn't okay for your shoulders, you can release your palms. You can have them, your palms facing each other. You can have that towel. Allow your head to be soft. And breathe. Releasing your fingertips down to the ground. We're going to inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Taking your right hand on the center of your mat or the floor, you're going to bring that left hand or your left fingertips up toward the sky. If you want to add in a little bit of a bind here, to, again, open through your shoulders, you can start to tuck your left hand onto your right thumb here. You can see it. But, and then start to open up your upper body toward the ceiling.
Left fingertips go back to the ceiling. Trade places with that right hand, left hand in the center. Right fingertips go up to the sky. Again, maybe you drop that right hand to your left thigh and start to open up your upper body towards the ceiling. Just options. Nice. Right fingertips go up to the sky. Come back down. You can heel toe your feet a little closer. We'll come into a squat. Again, there's tons of variations of this or a deep squat. You can, if your hips are super open and you want to work on strengthening, you don't have to go down as far. You can stay here. It's like this, thumbs out. You want to release into your squat a little deeper. Then here we are. And breathe. You're just going to take your right hand down to the mat, and then you can bring your left arm on the outside of that arm, or left arm on the outside of your left leg. Maybe you bring your right arm around. Maybe that's next class. You need to come out of the squat for a moment. That's okay. I'm not going to be here much longer. Just long enough to release and do the other side. So right arm's gonna wrap around, and then you just stay here, or left hand can join it, coming into a twist here. You get to choose. Nice. And then slowly release. Bring your hands behind you. Facing back down to your bum, extend your legs out, shake them out, point and flex, roll for your ankles a bit. Nice. And sit up tall again. You can always use your arms as a gauge here. Inhale, fingertips to ceiling, toes stay active. Exhale, come into a fold here. You need to keep a nice bend in your knees. And remember, whenever we're working on getting a little deeper, it doesn't really matter where your hands are. They can be by your shins. You're working with getting your chest towards your thighs, not your forehead towards your legs. It may happen, but that's what we're working on. It helps keep the spine in proper alignment. Why do you do so many forward folds? It's really good for your legs. It's really good for your hips. Most of us walk around with tight lower backs. Do you feel our legs being super tight? Releasing your bind, slowly rolling back up to seated. Bring your hands behind you. You're going to open up your chest and chin to the ceiling for a little bit of a back bend here. Come back to center. Taking your feet wide, and then you can just windshield wiper your legs from side to side. You can add in a twist if you like. Probably go a little bit deeper at this point since we've been practicing for a bit. When we're on each side, I have snuggles today because the hours are super wonky. My apologies. Nice. Coming back to those straight legs. Extend your arms out like Frankenstein arms. Straight back to start. And then we're going to slowly start to release down, keeping your feet active, keeping your core engaged as slowly as you can. Stretch. Nice. And then bring your knees into your chest, giving yourself a squeeze here. more things here. Take your arms wide. Just do a little bit of core here. So you're gonna, you can keep your feet or your legs on the mat, your ankle. If that doesn't work, you can bring them a little bit closer into your, into your chest. See if you can bring them to like 90 degrees. Then we're gonna take them up to the right and hover. Come back to center. Take them over to the left and hover. Back to center, keeping your core tight, keeping your legs pressed together. We'll do this a few more times on each side. One more time on each side, and then we'll hold all the way on the floor for the twist. Left side. We'll hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and release your knees into this twist. Again, we're working on our shoulders, releasing to the mat. Your upper body should be soft. And breathe. You can look straight ahead. You can move your head to one side or the other, just depending on the health of your neck. Shoulders relaxing towards the mat. Engage through your core, coming back through center. You can bring your arms, wrap your arms around your knees, bring your head, engaging every all the muscles that you possibly can. And then release everything down to the mat. One more little stretch. Bring your left leg over your right, left wrist and right hand, kind of making like a banana shape. I'm going to get through one more side body stretch. If stacking your feet doesn't work, that's okay. You just have them side by side. Nice. Releasing him back through center. Left leg, right leg over left. Right wrist and left hand. And then a nice side body stretch. Center. You can come into a little ball and roll.